Welcome to the fourth video in the Energy Policy Simulator, or EPS, overview series. This video discusses the model's input data and the process of adapting the EPS to different countries or regions. The EPS has been designed to minimize the time and effort required to adapt the tool to new geographies. To do this, the simulator is separated into two parts, the model structure and the input data. The EPS's core structure, which consists of computer code, is region neutral. The structure is flexible, allowing many choices to be set via input data. Sometimes, the EPS is able to simulate one interaction in different ways. For example, in the electricity sector, the EPS can simulate market-driven least-cost dispatch of power plants, or it can simulate dispatch under non-market systems where certain electricity producers are given priority. The model's input data contain the values that may vary from region to region. For example, the number of cars on the roads, the costs of different fuels, and even the elasticities that describe behavioral responses to price changes may be customized. If you wish to create an EPS version for a new country or region, the main task is to update the input data set. This will not require computer programming. All of the work is accomplished in a spreadsheet program. When this video was filmed, EPS versions had been created for 8 regions. With decent access to data sources about the new region and the ability to work quickly and accurately in a spreadsheet program, adapting the EPS for a new geography requires about 8 person weeks. Thus, a team of 2 may be able to accomplish it in a month. In the previous video, we covered obtaining a copy of the EPS and the purpose of the files included in the download package. This video focuses on the contents of the input data folder. Inside input data, you see a list of folders corresponding to different parts of the model, such as additional outputs or building sector. At the bottom are 2 files, acronym key and CPI. CPI stands for Consumer Price Index and contains information used to adjust currency for inflation in various input data files. The acronym key is the best place to start, so let's open it up. The acronym key spreadsheet contains 3 tabs. The About tab contains important information about how to interpret this file. The Key to Variables tab contains a listing of all of the input data variables. The first column indicates the folder that contains each input variable. The second column indicates each input variable's acronym, which is used in the variables folder and data file names. The third column specifies the meaning of each acronym. Sometimes, more than one input variable is generated from the same spreadsheet file under a single acronym. In these cases, all input variables are listed in the fourth column. The fifth column is relevant only if you are adapting the EPS to a new geography. While all of the input data may be replaced, it is typically not necessary to replace everything. The fifth column indicates how important it is to update the variable with local data during the adaptation process. Variables of very high importance vary greatly from region to region and have a large impact on the outputs of the EPS, particularly energy use and emissions. For example, in the building sector, BAU components energy use is of very high importance. This is because different regions contain different numbers of buildings and experience different weather, so the energy used by buildings varies greatly. Variables of high importance are similar to those of very high importance, but they affect values that are less central to the results of the EPS. For example, the BAU amount spent on building components varies widely from country to country, but getting this value wrong will primarily affect the model's financial outputs, and it will have only a small effect on energy use or emissions outputs. Variables of medium importance are those whose values differ by region, but leaving a U.S. value in place would not result in completely unreasonable outputs. Many elasticities, such as the elasticity for building service demand with respect to energy cost, are of medium importance. In the real world, consumers' sensitivity to price changes varies by country, for example, due to differences in average household income. But at least the U.S. elasticity has the right sign and is of the right order of magnitude. Variables of low importance may not vary much from country to country, or U.S. values are likely to be a reasonable approximation of local values. One example in the building sector is component lifetime, which expresses the number of years that building components are in service before they are replaced. Many components, such as ovens or air conditioners, are manufactured in a few countries and sold all over the world, and we generally would not expect that the average oven sold in one country will last many more or many fewer years than the average oven sold in another country. There are two other importance designations, to be determined via calibration and not applicable. These variables do not require country-specific input data during the adaptation process. Now let's look at the format of one of the input data variables. First, we open the industry folder. Next, we open the BIFUBC folder, which stands for BAU Industrial Fuel Use before CCS. One Microsoft Excel file with .xlsx extension and one or more comma-separated values files with .csv extension is in each input variables folder. The Excel file contains input data, puts it in the format expected by the EPS, and exports it to CSV. The CSV files are read by the EPS model at runtime. We never edit CSV files directly. Instead, we make changes inside the Excel file and overwrite the old CSV files. Let's look inside this variable's Excel file. Every Excel file begins with an About tab, which provides thorough bibliographic information for the variable's data sources. This promotes transparency and verifiability, core goals of the EPS design philosophy. For some variables, written comments appear below the bibliographic information. These comments may explain any input data nuances, or they may describe procedures or assumptions used to convert or reformat input data to match the format expected by the EPS. Each input variable's Excel file typically has one or more gray-colored tabs containing the input data itself. This is also where any necessary calculations are performed to ensure the data have the required format for use in the EPS. Finally, a variable's Excel file will have one or more tabs colored dark blue. These tabs are designed to be exported to CSV format. Each CSV file must have the same name as its tab in the Excel file. Each region may add input data in whatever format is best for that region in gray-colored tabs, but must manipulate it to match the format in the blue-colored tabs prior to export. In other words, when adapting the EPS to a new region, it is typical to delete and replace gray-colored tabs, but to keep blue-colored tabs, merely changing their formulas to refer to the new input data. One variable here is unlike the others. Rather than defining input data, it defines the implementation schedule for policies. Therefore, it affects policy scenarios, not the business-as-usual scenario. First, we open the Policy Schedule folder, then the FOPITY folder, which stands for Fraction of Policy Implemented This Year. This folder contains an Excel file and a series of CSV files. Some model distributions may have more than one Excel file, one per policy implementation schedule. The U.S. model is distributed with only one schedule. The Policy Schedule Excel file is similar to the files for input data variables. The first tab, called About, explains how to use the file. The second tab, called Set Schedules Here, is where we define the implementation percentage of each policy in each year. Every policy has two rows, a row of years and a row of implementation fractions. The implementation fractions must be between 0 and 1. A 0 means the policy is not in effect, while a 1 means the policy is in effect at the user's chosen setting, which is set in VenSim Model Reader. For example, if the user specifies a carbon tax rate of $50 per ton CO2 equivalent in VenSim, then the carbon tax rate will be $50 per ton in years where the implementation fraction is 1. The EPS linearly interpolates between data points that you enter. The first year and the last year of the model run must always have their implementation percentages specified. For example, suppose you want a policy to phase in from 2020 through 2030. The corresponding implementation schedule uses zeros in 2017 and 2019, as well as ones in 2030 and 2050. To phase in a policy along a more complicated shape, such as a curve, specify an implementation fraction for each year in the model run so the points follow the shape of your desired curve. When you are done setting the schedule you want, it is time to rename, save, and export the schedule. The EPS can handle up to 9 different policy implementation schedule files. We don't want to overwrite the default schedule, which has number 1. We begin by changing the number in the name of the two blue tabs from 1 to 2. If we already had a schedule number 2, we would use the next available number up to a maximum of 9. Next, we select the Save As command, change the number in the name from 1 to 2, and give it a descriptive name. Finally, we export the two blue tabs to CSV format, just as we would for any other input data file. Each CSV file uses the file name of the tab that was used to create it. The first blue tab exports the schedule in the format used by VenSim Model Reader, and the second blue tab exports to a format used for reference scenarios when deploying the model inside its web application interface. The EPS comes with CSV schedule files for numbers 2 through 9 formatted for use in VenSim. These are copies of the default schedule, and it is safe to overwrite them. The last step is selecting your chosen policy implementation schedule and adding this selection to your policy package. The previous video in the series discussed how to set policy levers and create a scenario. Enter SynthesIM mode, load your scenario, and set this lever to a number matching the number of your policy implementation schedule, 2 through 9. Then save your scenario, overwriting its old .cin file. Now, in addition to your policy settings, the number of your selected implementation schedule is saved into the scenario and will be automatically applied when the scenario is loaded. This concludes our overview of the simulator's input data, the process of adapting the EPS to new countries, and how to use policy implementation schedules. This is the 4th video in a series about the EPS. The other videos provide an overview of the simulator, a tour of its web interface, and a look at the tool's inner workings. Links to these videos appear in the comments field.